make me the host from the other device also. There I can see two Joji Pauls.
Okay. Najib sir, one more Joji Paul device will be there. Can you make
which
that
one
also?
Which one that? In the same name?
In the same name.
Let me try.
Joji sir, among the
participants... This meeting is being recorded.
Joji sir?
Yes sir, yes sir. Yeah.
In the participants list, I think only one Joji Paul has been.
I'm not able to see that one.
There are two.
Both are there, sir. There are two, sir. You can search there, Joji Paul. You will find it. Two accounts are there. One is with the phone.
Yeah, one is with the JP that has already been made as co-host. Other one is there with the profile picture is there.
I'm trying to find out that one.
Am I audible? Is my voice clear?
You are audible. Your voice is clear.
Yes, yes.
And you are visible also.
Thank you.
Which is the one you want to make? It's already there. Where you?
One profile picture, one more Joji Paul is there, sir.
Is there? I'm searching. I have 13 pages.
If you type at the search option, you will get it, sir. Najib, sir.
Hey.
Najib, sir, you can, on the top, okay. There is a search bar.
You just type, you will get, sir.
No, he has removed from me. Removed me from the...
Yeah. No, I did not remove anyone. I am seeing you, sir.
No, sir, I'll join once again.
Okay, sir.
You are unable to join the meeting because you were previously removed by the host.
You are there, sir, in the video.
No, he was trying to join with the second device.
One more device.
I'm talking about the second device.
As a substitute.
I'm already there in the meeting with video. Yeah, I've been made as the co-host also. I had joined from the other device also and was removed. No problem. But
we'll continue, sir, then.
You please give me the message when it is not visible to you, when there is any interruption from my end. Normally, I check it from the second device and I share something from some tools from the mobile also, but that may not be possible for me this time. Anyway, no problem.
Second instrument is mobile phone?
Second one is mobile. No, I'm not there in the meeting. I've been sent out. Okay, no problem.
You can try to rejoin, na, Joji sir.
But not able to. Because since I have been removed, I cannot join back.
Okay. Participants are requested to turn off their microphones. Okay, Badhizaman sir, shall we start then?
Yes, yes. Okay.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Most respected Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Badhizaman sir. Our respected CEO, Engineer Najib sir. My fellow office bearers, dear colleagues and my dear teachers. Today we have assembled on a mega platform for a training on the effective uses of online tools by one of the most reputed RPs in the CBSE fraternity, none other than Joji Paul sir. Let us begin this occasion with a prayer. I request Umair sir to perform the kiraat. Umair sir.
Yes, sir. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين صدق الله صدق.
Thank you, sir. Let me take this opportunity to welcome our most respected Chief Executive Officer of Integrated Education Council India, Dr. Badil Zaman sir. Today we have assembled, as I mentioned, for an online session on the effective uses of online tools. And we have with us one of the most popular, if I use one of the most popular, that may be a wrong adjective. He is not one of the most popular, he is the most popular RP in the CBSE fraternity. We have an association, very close association during this last 1 year. And actually with, I have been watching Joji sir with an envy and pride that how a human being is managing to conduct so many training sessions. When we have been managing an average 8 or 12 session in Thiruvananthapuram COE, Center of Excellence, Joji sir had topped the list in 2020-21, conducting 28 training sessions, scheduled training sessions for COE Thiruvananthapuram only. He has been conducting training sessions as an RP of different COEs all over India. And when I had a talk with him a few months back, I think 4 or 5 months back, he told me that he had completed 200 online sessions all over India. And I understand that he might have crossed the number 300 within this time. Am I correct, Joji sir?
400 plus 420.
400. So it's a magical number. It's very difficult for a normal human being. That's why I consider him as a super human being among the RPs and not one of the most popular RPs, but the most popular RP in the CBSE fraternity. The plus point of Joji sir is a totally committed person who never gets into a session without spending his maximum time to learn about the session. I do not have much time because he has got another session immediately after our session, 4:30 he has another session. So we have cut short the welcome session and the total introduction session, and we are trying to wind up at the earliest so that the floor is open for you. So without much ado, I take this opportunity to welcome today's RP, Georgie Paul sir, to this platform.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
I welcome our respected CEO, Engineer Najib sir, my dear colleagues, and all dear participants. Only I have one message to you. When we cook any dish item, that dish item may not be, or that dish may not be tasted equally by all the people. Some people will love it more, some people may not love it. Some love salty, some love spicy, some love hot, some love sour. So the tastes differ. So if we want to please the people who taste the food, we have to cater according to their taste. The same is applicable in the field of education also, in the case of learning also. The only request I have to place in front of you is just to see whether the food that we cater, the learning that we cater, cater to the taste of our learning community. Once again, welcoming you all to this occasion and welcoming our respected Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Badiu Zaman sir, for the inaugural address. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum. Over to Dr. Badiu Zaman sir.
A very warm good afternoon, all of you. Assalamu alaikum. We are very happy today because we have got a very eminent personality as we people, and to sharpen our weapons for meeting, for confronting with the coming education year. Last year, when the Corona-19 has erupted suddenly, what we had thought was that it may end soon. And maximally we have expected that, of course, the year 2020-21, the previous academic year, maybe a Corona year, and we had some problems. And positively, we were expecting that in the next year, the things will be over. But again, unfortunately, by the will of God Almighty, this year also, we are facing the very same problem. IECI, Integrated Education Council India, as all of us know, a Calicut-based educational NGO, which is having 100 plus schools under its aegis. We are organizing the school activities under the name Vidya Council for Education. And last year, what we have done is that our teachers have tried their best to, and they could make the challenge as an opportunity, if I'm using a cliche. And they had tried their best. But this year, what we have thought that our teaching fraternity don't have any excuse of confronting with a novel situation, because already we are passing through this kind of a phase and we are having different platforms of online teaching for past 1 year. So this year, we thought that in the very outset itself, in the very beginning itself, our teachers should be equipped to have their online classrooms effective. And IECI, as the umbrella organization, thought that it is our responsibility to give some sort of training to our teachers. But by the grace of God Almighty, again, Alhamdulillah, we have got a very eminent personality who is having a lot of experience in this field. And I'm sure that many of you people might have already attended his sessions. So my request to my fellow teachers is to utilize this opportunity to your maximum and make the next academic year an effective one to to all the stakeholders involved. In the name of God Almighty, I announce that this session is being opened. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Thank you. Thank you all.
Now let me take this opportunity to invite Dr. Salil Hassan, General Secretary of IECA CBSE School Principals Association Council and the principal of Ansar English School, to present the profile of today's RP. Salil sir.
Yes, thank you Prakash sir. Am I audible?
Yes sir.
So I am very much privileged and delighted to introduce the resource person for the today's training session. It is Mr. Georgie Paul, Principal Benchmark International School, Tirur. He is the President of Malappuram Sahodaya and Joint Secretary of Confederation of Kerala State School Sahodayas. He has 3 post-graduations to his credit in English, Economics and Psychology, along with B.Ed. He is a constant learner. He has got many postgraduate diploma and certificate courses in computer application, guidance and counseling, English teaching, teaching in English, then educational management and administration. He is an international trainer, academic consultant, a psychologist, and of course, a career coach too. He has been training under the banner of State Headquarters Commissioner of Hindustan Scouts and Guides. He is one of the prominent city coordinator of National Testing Agency. He is the resource person for CBSE Center of Excellence, Trivandrum, Chennai, Delhi East, Pune, Dehradun. And he is working with Macmillan Publishers India Private Limited. He's a resource person for National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research. He conducted, it has already been expressed by Prakash Varia, Mr. Prakash Varia. He has been conducting more than 412 online sessions for CBSE Trivandrum, Chennai, Delhi, Pune, Dehradun. He has conducted professional development training on child-friendly classrooms. He has done many workshops for Ministry of Education, Republic of Maldives. He has conducted leadership training programs for the managers and principals of various CBSE Sahodayas and management associations. He is busy with conducting capacity building programs for principals and teachers for CBSE COEs Chennai and Trivandrum. He has done many teacher empowerment training programs, parental sessions, more than 1,200 schools in India, Maldives, Bahrain, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and UAE. And these schools comprise of CBSE, ICSE, IGSE, IGCSE, Navodaya, and State Board. So I don't want to prolong much. So we have got an eminent trainer for today's session. Along with you, I welcome Mr. Georgie Paul to open the session. Thank you.
Georgie Paul, sir?
Yes, sir.
The floor is open to you. We don't have to waste any more time. Your minutes are very valuable. Over to you, sir.
Okay, sir. Yeah, we'll start. Respected Dr. Mohammad Yusaman, CEO of IECI. Respected Mr. Prakash Varia, the Chairman, CBSE Schools Principals Council associated with IECI. Dr. Salil Hassan, General Secretary. Respected principals from various Vidya Council schools. You may please take it as my personal greeting. Unfortunately, I cannot say or I cannot greet you looking at your faces here because we have some restrictions and limitations. We are meeting online. Because I've been associated with many of these schools. I've been to many schools. I conducted sessions and many of these principals, veteran principals, are my friends. So a hi to you everyone. And teachers who have joined from these schools, good afternoon to you. We have 357 participants, including the resource person.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, Good afternoon, madam. Sophia, ma'am, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. So here we have 350 plus participants, and we are going to talk about technology, the tools. And Prakash sir, you please give me some notifications, information, in case if my presentation is not visible, if my audio is not audible.
Definitely, sir.
Because, you know, I don't have the second device here. So
of
you
course, sir. Me. Of course, sir.
Yeah. Thank you very much. So I just would like to start the session with a question. I know that these schools, the schools under Vidya Council, almost all the schools, not almost, all the schools have been doing very well. You are paying much attention in providing quality education. There's no doubt about it. I do appreciate you. Most of your leaders are very good researchers. Nothing will be implemented without a very detailed and serious study. I know that. Since I have been associated with you people, many of you are my friends also. So I know how beautifully you are conducting online classes for the students. See, I just would like to tell you two things. I do appreciate you for this. I'll connect one term, that is summer slide. Have you heard of summer slide? Have you discussed with about the summer slide or read anywhere summer slide? Have you heard of this? If you can, you can just raise your hands and put it in the chat box also. Summer slide is a phenomenon. That was a serious one, and that was experienced by all the educators. See, at the end of the academic year, children will be very smart, very efficient in languages and numeracy, in literacy and numeracy. But after 2 months vacation, when they come back to schools, a kind of hiccups would be felt. That is summer slide. A slide in the summer due to lack of educational activities, especially reading, arithmetic, writing, etc. This is summer slide. And that was too much in United States of America, because they had an extended vacation than most of the Asian countries. We have 2 months here. They have more than two, like 2 months and 3 weeks and 4 weeks, like 3 months. So there were a series of studies conducted there in United States, and Brookings Institute also conducted a study. And as per that study, they made it in their report, and that was publicized among the educators. 3 months learning gap is equal to 14 months learning loss. 3 months learning gap is equal to 14 months learning loss. We stopped our physical classrooms, physical classes in the month of March 2020. And thereafter, how many months? 15 months. That means 3 months, 5 into 14, almost 70. 70 months learning loss. You managed that very well. Otherwise, it would have been a big loss, an irreparable, irrecoverable loss. So I do appreciate you. We had synchronous learning platforms last year. We opened up, we created, we customized the online synchronous platforms. And that is what suggested. It was suggested directly from the Ministry of Human Resource Development that online synchronous classes to be given to the students from classes 1 to 12. You provided that. Synchronous, live sessions, face-to-face sessions, interactive sessions. And the government was giving asynchronous sessions. Government schools and aided schools were giving asynchronous sessions. Recorded videos were sent through TV channels or websites. That was asynchronous. So instead of asynchronous, we used online synchronous platforms. That's great. That helped us to reduce the learning gaps in children, learning losses in children. So online classes, effective online classes were helpful in reducing the learning losses in children up to an extent, not completely. Still, we have to work on that. The second thing that was very much helpful for us to establish or continue with our routines and rituals. A school-going child normally wakes up in the morning, will have its routines to be completed with it before going to the school, breakfast, taking bath, everything. Then we'll get ready for the bus, we'll catch the bus and reach the school. Thereafter, periods. At the end, they'll complete the schooling, then we'll go back Right? So this routine was missed somewhere. Majority of the students in and around your schools, you might have noticed and experienced, were like in a holiday mode. They were in a holiday mode, a lazy approach. They had no routine, they had no time, they had no stipulated time, because the recorded videos were available even for a second time or later, at a later time. It was not necessary to attend. It was not necessary for them to get ready, but you made it mandatory. And these rituals and routines are very much important for the children, because these are the things that help them to reach a successful career, professional, personal, social, right, status. For these statuses, it is required. So you ensured that routines and rituals also. And the third one, it was very much helpful in establishing social connections. And those social connections enabled them to overcome the stress. And it was very much helpful for you to interact with the children. Had it been without these social interactions, what would have been the result? You would have been under stress. It was anticipated. WHO, World Health Organization, they expected that by 2030, not before, not after this COVID pandemic, even before that, that was expected. By 2030, most of the people would be affected in the world with depression. Depression was one of the dangerous diseases, as researched by the WHO. And they said that by 2025, most of the Indians would be affected with the depression. When we are not having solutions for our problems, we'll have depression. Now you just see, Corona is also giving a lot of stress to the workers, whoever, whatever is the work, wherever they are. And we could overcome that with social connections with the children. How much it was for the children. Think about that. Because when they were stranded in their respective houses, they had very limited vocabulary to communicate with their parents. There is a limit for that vocabulary. And they had very limited discussions or topics for the communication within the home. When they got you from the other side of the screen, it was a relief for them, really. When they got their friends, though they were not close physically far, it was a feeling that they are together. This is the same feeling I have with you people here. I'm talking to you. Pragas sir and Salil sir said I have done more than 400 CBSE sessions. True, but I was talking to the screen. But always I had a feeling that I was talking to the human beings. There are human beings who are curiously, inquisitively watching and listening, waiting for each and every dialogue that I deliver. That was the only reason why I could complete that. And due to these reasons, our online classes are important, very much important. Last year, state board schools provided asynchronous coachings, and this year they have decided to give online classes also. May I request everyone to mute the microphone, please? Thank you. So they have decided to give synchronous classes. So what would be the difference? Last year, our career columnist, career guru, PS Warrior commented in the beginning itself, the online classes which are provided by CBSE schools are best in the nature. And so the same online classes to be provided in other schools, government schools and aided schools. It was a recommendation and many recommended the same. So they are coming up with this. They'll be doing these two together simultaneously. One synchronous, other one asynchronous. So both will be available for the schools and teachers. Customized G Suite account will be given to the individual schools, and teachers working in a particular school will handle online classes like what we are doing through G Suite or Zoom platform to the students. So the same will be available even there. So we should be different. And if you give the same what they provide, there will be no difference. And there will be tendency for the people to take the children out of the CBSE circle. There will be no stoppage for the migration. So this has to be minimized with a better, effective, a quality teacher training. We can do that. We are smart enough for that. So here, I think my screen is visible to you, and I'll just share one link. Can you please comment here? What are the online classes? What were the online tools used by you last year? I think I can share this here in the chat box, though you all cannot join, but still just try. It is a Mentimeter link. I just want to see which are the online tools used by you last year. Prakash sir, one more time. I hope it is visible, right?
Screen. The link is there in the chat box, sir. Also, it is visible. Yeah.
Hope the other one is also visible. Online tools used to last online year. Tools.
Yes, sir.
Screen
yes, sir.
Is also visible. Yeah, fine. Thank you. Please respond to this one so that I'll be able to plan my session accordingly. If you are using all what I'm going to share, it may not be required for you. Google Meet, Zoom are platforms. So please do away from sharing the platforms, because we know that we have different platforms like Zoom, Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, and Cisco WebEx. These are the tools. Yeah, you can see Mentimeter, Jamboard, Padlet, Google Forms, good. Google Slides. Yeah, fine, fine. Mentimeter. I'm also using a tool. It's a kind of interaction with the collaboration with the participants, right? Though you are from various parts of India, of Kerala, still you are able to respond to my screen, and I'm getting that on my screen, which is seen by everyone in the meeting. A possibility in the classroom as well. Those who haven't tried this, we will not be spending time on this Mentimeter, because this is known to many. At least a few teachers in each school will be using, maybe using this. So this is a platform where you can connect and link with the participants, and they will have the curiosity throughout. They will maintain the curiosity that the teacher may share any of these kind of tools anytime, so that I must participate. And with a single Mentimeter, two slides, question slides or polling slides, and 5 quiz slides can be created. That's free account. The paid account more can be created, but as of now, that paid account is not required. I have been using this for almost all the online sessions, but I have never paid anything. It's not required. A payment is not mandatory. Fine. Yeah. Once again, I request everyone to mute the microphone. A couple of microphones are unmuted. Yeah, thank you. Once again, try once again. Everyone, you please check. Yes, thank you. So these are the ones. So look here, we have been using Jamboard, Google Classroom, we have been Poplet, GeoGebra, Mind Mapping, Whiteboard, Google Form, QSIS, Padlet, Google Slide. Almost all the tools. So make sure that you use these tools for your online classes, so that there will be curiosity for the children. Parents will also see that in addition to the verbal sessions through the microphone or the PowerPoint presentation, they have many tools. So they'll have a confidence that the learning will never be interrupted. Many parents complain that children are least bothered and they are not at all interested in the classes. They just put an earphone and hear. There is a difference between hearing and listening. What is hearing? Unintentional. With an earphone or a connectivity, they'll hear. Let that hearing be a listening. Intention is required. Interest is required. Curiosity is required. So with this intention, interest, curiosity, inquisitiveness, they'll do. They will respond. Many students who are very weak in offline sessions became very smart in online sessions because of this interaction. They hesitated to come to the blackboard or whiteboard in the classroom, but when it was available on their fingertip, they participated and actively took part in the activities. So this is very important. Make sure that you have some tools. I'll also suggest some tools which can be used other than this. And some of these, if required, can also be discussed here. The second one, I'll share one more. That is my Padlet. You said you used many Padlets. Here is another Padlet, which will also be shared in the chat box. Yes, here is it. Click on this Padlet and join and comment here. What were the practical difficulties faced by you? Only one, and the most difficult practical problem that you faced must be written here. I may not be able to attend all the questions, all the practical problems, but still I'll try to resolve some of the issues. No ready-made solution available for us, but if we can utilize our resources, available resources, that two free resources, definitely we'll be able to resolve that one. So you may please. Hope the Padlet link is available. Yeah. Just 1 minute activity. Within 1 minute, hope you will send the messages. See, I'm sharing this with my participants and you are my participants. Similarly, when you share in your schools, you are the resource person, teacher, and your students will be able to respond like this. See, this is Padlet. This Padlet is also a smart tool. Here you can ask the children to respond individually. You can limit the participants, like a particular sport can be allotted to a particular participant, so that will be an individual task. See, you can give a pair task, pair work here. A group work can be done here. And what all things can be shared here by the participants? Their answers, their queries, their responses, their thoughts and feelings through words. And the same can be recorded through audio. Audio recorded materials can also be sent. Okay. Now I speak. I can record this in the Padlet and share it in the Padlet. A video as such, you know, I am visible to you. The same can be recorded as a video and the same can be shared in the Padlet. You can share any YouTube link from the Padlet. Okay. And you can write there, read there, I mean, draw there. May I request once again? Shall we, sir? Sir, shall we make one? Now the co-hosts are already here, right? It is better if we can mute everyone. If we can mute everyone, and at the end, in the end, if required, we will unmute. We will unmute and allow them to unmute. Otherwise, there will be disturbance in between, right? Because we have more than 350. Some of all may not be very smart in operating the devices. So, can you please do that? Mute everyone. Without giving the option for unmuting themselves. There are two options. When you mute them all, there is an option.
Joji sir, your mic is muted.
Yeah, now I unmuted. Fine. Hope everyone has been muted. Thank you. Thank you very much. These are the practical.
No, sir, not still.
We are trying, but it's not working. I'm trying.
The thing is that, sir, there is an option that you have to tick that one. There is a text box. When that pops up, that message pops up, there is a tick box, that checkbox to be done. And that is to unmute participants.
Then yes. Okay. Now you can unmute, sir. Joji, sir.
Now I think it is clear. It's fine now, right? I'm audible, sir. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, you are audible.
Yes. Yeah, sometimes becomes a distraction for the students. I didn't get it, but let's see. Most of the students were helped by the parents. Let's forget that part. If their parents helped them, let that be done. We cannot do much there. We do wish to conduct examinations and classes the same way how it was during our offline days. But you see, we are going without a class 10 examination and we are in uncertainty whether the class 12 examination will be conducted or not. So let's don't focus on the examination part. That is an assessment. Let us ensure that they get the content, concept, and that understanding be ensured. Forget the examination. If public board examinations are cancelled, why should we focus on that particular class examination or annual examination? Okay, let there be quality in the teaching and learning. That's the network problems. We don't have solutions. So let me just go through this content. Sometimes they are not attending, playing with the phone, lack of eye contact, network issue, can't see, multiple use of gadget, internet speed, participation of the students are less, but parents helping behind the screen, copying answers in exam, strength of classes comparatively high, students multiple. If there is any special point, you can also note down. Pragas sir and team. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sir, if there is any particular point, see. The first point, network, forget that part. We cannot do much. Network. Last year, they had excuse, we had excuse. Parents said, we never prepared for this. Teachers said, we never thought that this would be a teaching model method for us, a platform for us. Yeah. But you cannot say that this time. Communicate the same to the parents that they cannot raise this complaint. This year, the connectivity issues would be more than last year, because if government schools and aided schools are also providing synchronous learning, those many students will also be attending online classes. And that will also be in the daytime when we give the online classes. So bandwidth issues would be there. If parents and teachers depend on mobile connectivity, you cannot ensure uninterrupted connectivity. There will be interruption. Especially in the first half when we have rainy season, right? In first half, a couple of months will be rainy. So advise them, suggest them a broadband or network connectivity, because most probably in the primary classes, this will be extended till the end. And even if it is over, if they come back to the classroom, still we will use this virtual platform for flipped classroom. This is a buzzword in education. Have you heard about that? Have you ever thought of this buzzword? Flipped classroom, a reversal of the existing conventional classroom. In the present classrooms, children come to classroom, they learn from there, then go back to home, they complete their learning from home. A complete reversal will happen. They'll start learning from home. How is it possible for the teachers? Because teachers will be able to send their podcasts and materials and videos through these virtual platforms. They'll get it, children, and they'll start preparing for the class. Then they'll come to the classrooms and the learning will be completed in the classroom with the teachers and friends. So a reversal, it's possible. Remedial coaching will be possible for us. Intensive coaching will be possible. Exam point of view coaching will be possible. Anything, anytime, it is possible. So blended learning will be followed. Blended, both online and offline. A mixing of these two, blended. These are the two buzzwords you can expect in education in the coming days. Let's be ready for that. And NEP says, National Education Policy 2020 advocates many online digital platforms and strategies. Flipped and blended learning is, these two are recommended through NEP. It's suggested. It's included in the recommendations. And wherever it is, whether it is online or offline, competency-based learning should happen. Competency-based teaching should happen. And assessment will also be competency-based. That's all. So with these inputs, let me just take my session. I'll just tell you, you said, we don't know whether they are attending our session or not. I suggested activities, curiosity, arouse the curiosity of the children. When you show them something, if it is worth watching and listening or attending, they will do that. For example, now I don't know how many of you are very much serious about an online learning on online tools here with this virtual Zoom platform. But now I'll give you something for your curiosity, to arouse your curiosity. You see here is Google Earth. Look here from this Google Earth. I'm going to launch this Google Earth. And here you just see. We are adults, we are elders, we are 30s, we are in our 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. Still, there will be no hesitation to accept this platform, this tool. Since we have more people in the platform, it's taking a bit time. Please wait. Yeah. I think you remember this. We all had this in our staff rooms, right? A plastic material, right? This is Globe. And this is a live Globe for you. It's available there. Even that, with that plastic Globe, we used to have some researchers, right? Where is this America? We asked ourselves and our friends also, where is this America? Why is this America far from here? And where is this Australia? We had these doubts. Do you want to see this? Do you want to show this to children? Not geography alone. Even when you teach some history, if there are some monuments, some particular places, you can take them through a virtual expedition. See, here is it. We are talking much about Lakshadweep. Where is this Lakshadweep? When you teach the children about islands, you can tell them that we have, India has two different island groups. One is in the Arabian Sea, that is Lakshadweep, and there is in Bay of Bengal, Andaman Sea. And Lakshadweep islands are coral islands, and Andaman islands are not coral, natural islands. So you see, let's go to this Lakshadweep. This is Lakshadweep. How far is it from Kozhikode, Kannur, Thrissur? Very close. One of these islands are here. This is island. So the concept of island will be crystal clear for the children when you teach them like this. A piece of land which is surrounded by water on all sides. Okay. Coral. Shallow water can be seen, and coral deposits will be there in the banks. And these coral deposits make it shallow. You can teach them. See, let's go to Kavrati. Yeah, here in... This is Kavrati. A small piece of land, right? How is life in an island? Let's take them to this. Do you want to go zoom? Yes, here is. Will the children be curious? Please tell me. Are you curious now? If yes, if your answer is yes, if you want to see, if you curiously looked at the screen and anticipated some places, some, you know, buildings, a boat jetty, that is the same you can do with the children. they will also be curious. Now you go deep. This is island. This is one of the islands. One of the islands in Lakshadweep. And this is Kavrati, its capital. And we have been talking about this for these days. During these days, we talk. Will they be interested? Children? Of course, right? Yeah, this is one of the stars. This is available free of cost. You can take them to any place. How many times we taught them there is a leaning tower, right, of Pisa, which is in Italy. Just click there. That's all. It will take you to Italy. No train, airfare, nothing is there. You are here in a better way than what Italians see. Look, this is that leaning tower of Pisa. If it is included in your English literature, you can show them. Let them have the imagination. You see, this is leaning tower of Pisa. Can you see this? Yeah. From Italy, if you just want to go to another place, Eiffel Tower. Eiffel Tower, Paris. We'll be taken to Paris as well. And here is Paris. This is Eiffel Tower. Let's go to the top of the Eiffel Tower. This is that. It's an aerial view, right? Yeah. Is this learning interesting? If you want to go to any place in the world, it's possible. And see, the sense, geographical, topographical sense of the children will be improved. It will definitely be a good learning for them. They'll have some political sense, right? You know, the geographical borders, boundaries, topographies, how is life in an island and how is life in New York? They'll just move to New York and they'll see towering buildings in the New York. In the islands, only one single floor or, you know, single story building or two story maximum buildings can only be seen. But here in United States, it will be like towering buildings, tower like New York. Here, this is New York. Look, this is New York City. You don't complain to your principals that you were not taken for a picnic last year. You have a virtual picnic. The entire Vidya Council teachers are being taken for a trip now. And you are now in the United States of America. Look, these are the buildings there. See the constructions? You see the buildings? Can you see? Hope you can see this screen. Yeah. Hope yes, these are fine. Yeah, right. So please go through this. Any place. Now, I'm damn sure that after a few minutes or once this session is over, even before that, you might have started visiting some places, right? You will do this first because of its interest. The same is there with the children, will they be with the children, and teachers will find it very easy. The same, this globe can be downloaded. I was directly playing from my website. Website means, you know, from the browser. Google Earth. And in such occasions, you have to launch Google. Okay, Google Earth. And if you download Google Earth Pro, here is it. Here on this Google Earth Pro icon can be seen on the desktop. And if you download this app, this is a web app. It will work from here also. See, each and every country will be displayed with its boundaries. In addition to this, you can even make use of this. You can, if you want to mark a label or a particular place, it can be done. Latitude and longitude can be seen from here. And different, yeah, image overlay, many options are there. Just spend a few minutes with a Google tutorial, which is available from YouTube. You would be a smart teacher with this virtual tool. So this is a wonderful tool, not just for, I do repeat once again, this is not just for geography teachers alone. Anybody can use it. EVS teachers can use it. When you teach countries, you can teach it. Children will be very much interested, and even parents will come to watch how is learning happening in their classrooms. Many parents, these are new to them, and they too attend the classes, right? And this will definitely be attended by the parents. If any place is to be seen, you can take them to that place. So here you can see view is there. There are some structures here. Explore option is there from view. And from this explore, you can see Mars. Have you seen the picture of Mars? This is Mars. See the difference? Just zoom it maximum, but still we can't see anything other than this. a structure like this is Mars. And the structure of Sun is, Moon is also available. From to view, explore, Moon is also there.
So are you me. Sharing, sir? Or?
Yes, still I'm sharing. You cannot. Are you able to see this now?
The can you Earth see? Is visible.
No, only pardon? The previous globe is visible.
That globe is visible.
Only the previous globe.
Only that is seen.
New York.
I think that window you have not shared, I think, sir. Now you have exited now.
Now, can you see now?
Now it is visible.
Yeah, yeah. I'll take you. I'll tell you where did I take this from. So once again, this is Google Earth Pro, which is downloaded from my browser. And if you have this with you, it's an application, a downloaded application. So from here, you can view, look the menu bar. There's a view. And in the view, explore option is here. And in the explore, Mars. This is Mars.
Oh, okay, sir. Now it is visible.
It's visible now, right? Yeah. This is Mars. This is the structure of Mars. Now, again, in the view, there is one more. Explore. There's Moon. This is Moon. Different options are there. You check, go through these options. Places, sightseeing, tour is there. Places are there. Moon gallery. Many learning materials are available here with this Google Earth. Google Earth is a free package for the social science teachers and all the teachers. Okay. So I just wanted to give this as the first tool, just to tell you that if they are interested, they'll pay attention. And if they are not interested, they'll never pay attention. Many studies have revealed and established the fact that happy students tend to learn well. And in order to be happy in a classroom, they must be involved in the learning. That's why we are bringing art integration. That's why we are promoting experiential learning. They must be involved. They must be engaged. If you don't give any engagement, if you are not involving the students, if you keep on going with your oral explanation and visual presentation, they will not be interested in that. They must be a part of the process. So that is very important. So I can go to the next tool. And I don't know whether it is visible. What is seen now? Can you see my desktop now?
That Moon is visible, sir.
Only that is visible. So I think every time I have to stop it. Okay, fine. Now, again. Okay. Can you see my web browser?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Now see, it is Padlet. Oh, okay.
Maps of India. Just type Maps of India. Social studies teacher. There is a collection of free maps available for you. This is another practical difficulty faced by the social studies teachers. Look, mapsofindia.com. Almost all the maps are available free of cost. All these tools which I explained today are free. There's no expenditure required for that. Maps of India. It's an Indian map, political map of India. Look here, you can see most viewed maps of India, political map of India, states and capital map of India, railway map of India, physical map of India, India on world map. And if you click on this see all, if you click on this see all the maps will be displayed, including India history maps, world map, Indian freedom struggle map, a pre-partition map of India, ancient map, India map in 1956, and pocket maps of India. And you can download maps. This is another practical difficulty. Even during this pandemic, though you cannot go outside to purchase these outline maps, you can download it. And these downloaded maps can be sent to the Google Classrooms, or it can even be uploaded anywhere in the virtual platform. Any outline maps are available. Physical, political, A4 size map, India political map, all these maps are available. For example, if you want an Indian outline map, a physical map, look, this is available for download. Suppose if this is not available for download, still it is possible. Nowadays, what is our strategy to get the materials? We just screenshot, take the screenshot like this. If you can take screenshot, this has become a picture. Even the materials which are not downloadable, which has a copyright, can also be done. I'm not leading to unethical activities and all, but still, you know, there are harmless cases. There are some harmless activities.
They're only giving ideas.
Idea, right. So this is possible. Look, but this is free. It's downloadable one. There is no payment. Download free India map. Here you just download. This can be shared with the participants. They can also work here, right? They can also do this individually and they can upload it. It can be converted to a PDF, or even you can directly copy this and put it in the any of your file docs. And there you can share it with the participants. Okay. So many, all these things are there. Look, what are the other downloadable maps, outline maps available? Check it. Okay. And get it. Now, let me go to the next one. There is one. iXL.com. This is also a resource pool. I'm giving some resources now initially, then we'll go to the tools. Okay. This iXL, if you become a member, you have a limit. Only 10 questions can be answered. But I've been using this for almost all the online classes. iXL.com is a package for the students, LKG, UKG, class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5, till class 12. Mathematics and English skill enhancement activities are available. If you register and if you become a member, there is a limit. Otherwise, you will have to pay. But here you can check it. Not every day, you can suggest some of these activities to the children. Like in small classes, if you have KG teachers with you, don't know whether you have KG teachers, or if, let me take you to the third standard. If you go to mathematics skills in third standard, you will find these are some of the mathematics activities. More than 200 activities are given here. And here some, these are given by activities only. Even or odd activity is the first one. Look here, a small activity. This is maths, English is also there. Which of the following numbers are odd? 3, 86, 100, 17. Suppose if I click here, submit. Sorry, incorrect. I'll get the response and that explanation will be given. These were the numbers given. You answered 3. A number is odd if it ends in 1, 3, 5, 7, or 9. A number is even if it ends in 2, 4, 6, 8, or 0. You got it? These numbers are odd, 3 and 17. These numbers are even, 86 and 100. Got it? Even that explanation is given. Such activities are given here. Now again, which of the following numbers are even? And two numbers, if I give these two numbers up, yes, well done. You have done this well. So many such activities are available free. And if it asks some money at a later stage, I'll not be responsible. This is what they play. They have some tricks. Initially, they'll offer some free and they'll attract us. Then they'll charge something. But now, as of now, all these can be tested. But as a member, if you enroll, you will have to be limited with 10. Then otherwise, in order to continue further, you need to pay. So don't suggest this to the children. Instead, you can show in between. If you suggest, they'll come with that. They're asking money and we will have to pay money. And children will also demand too much payment from the parents. They'll insist them to pay. So you don't directly advise them to go for it. In between your sessions, when you have some revision tests and bridging activities, you can show them these activities. Okay. So this is from iXL.com. And I saw you made a comment there in the chat box. One is, you are using Google Slides. That's fine. You are using Google, PowerPoint from Microsoft. Those who use Google Slides can utilize a beautiful option that is Slido. Have you done Slido? If not, I'll just show you. How can you integrate Slido with your online Google Slide presentation? The first thing, you have to add an extension to your Google Chrome. So for that, Slido extension to Google. Just type from the search address bar, Slido extension to Google. And there you will find Slido for Google Slides from Google Workspace. Click on this one. Now you can see Slido is ready to be added. But in my case, it is showing uninstall message because I have already added, I have already installed. When you add this first time, it will show you installed. You can click on that install so that the Slido will be added to your Google Chrome extension. Okay. And this is an extension. Clear? I have already added, so it shows uninstalled. So I'll work with this. So the next is to open a Google slide. In order to take a Google slide, we have these three docks. These are gearbox. This is a gearbox, and all the Google apps can be seen in the gearbox. And one is slides, and this is slides. And this slide will be used. A slide. Any of the Google, almost all the Google apps can be opened with a plus button. Here is the plus button in the front, in the first row itself, and click on this plus button so that a new slide will be created. This is similar to your MS Word, MS PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint. And there is an advantage. It's very easy when we play online because only a single click is required. When you open a PowerPoint slideshow from beginning, from this slide, so many options, so many menus. All those menus may trouble you while you are in the presentation session. You are in a virtual session. But here, you know, if you have a PowerPoint that is in Google slide, just click here. It will present. Look, this is the thing. Presentation is possible. Click on escape key. You will come back to the normal condition. Again, after that, you can present. So this is the one. So normally, when you prepare your PPT, you will prepare for 40 minutes or 45 minutes, whatever is the duration of your session, right? Contents will be organized in that order. So slides or Google, I mean, PPT slide, PowerPoint slide will be prepared in accordance with that. Here, I'm going to make one for my 40-minute session. And during that session, I can integrate Slido activity also. You said children are less attentive because they don't have any involvement. You can involve them. At any time, they'll get an activity. If this feeling is there in their mind, they'll never look away from their screen. They'll always be looking at the screen very curiously. Look here. This is the title. You have physics topic to be taught to the children. So you had a title heading and you have contents here. Your teaching content is given here. This is physics, and your content will be added, the title will be added. So first slide is prepared and you will go to the second slide, and second slide is at a single click. Any theme can be chosen from here. These all are themes available free of cost. These all are part of this Google, and this is here. And in the second one, I know I'm not teaching actually. I'm not helping you to do this Google slides, which are very familiar to you. I'm going to integrate Slido with the Google slide so that without leaving your presentation screen, you can conduct activities, not one, not two, not three, any number of activities. Okay, so please look here. Second slide, you move to the second slide and you have a title here and you have points here. You add points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These points are explained. Then you will go to next slide. Next slide also will have some contents. Yeah, here and here. Slide number is here and it's done. Okay, different slides are here. All these are slides. And after this third slide, suppose if you want a Google Slido activity, click here on this Slido. Only those who add this extension to Google will be seeing this one. Others cannot see this here. Now I added, since I added Slido as an extension to Google Chrome and Google, it's appearing here. So click on this Slido. It looks green with an S symbol. Now you can see create a session. First time users must sign up. Second time onwards, you can sign in directly and create session. And if you don't log out of your account, you can use it continuously. See here, what are the options available for me? What are the activities I can conduct along with this Google? Multiple choice can be added. Open text can be added, word cloud can be added, rating can be added, ranking can be done, and quiz competition can also be conducted. What can this quiz be? This quiz can be an exit activity, right? Exit act after 40 minutes, if you conduct 3-4 quizzes, that will be the assessment and that will be the feedback. Their score will be their feedback as well, right? So here I'm going to start with multiple choice. How can you give multiple choice? Click on multiple choice. Here you can ask a question. Which is your favorite? And I'm not going to ask any physics related question. I'm going to ask a general one just to sensitize you. That's all. Which is your favorite online tool? This question and some options can be done. Maybe Google Forms, maybe Google Slides, another one Jamboard, another one Menti, and again a Parklet. See, I gave these 6 items. Similarly, you can also give some responses, answers as part of your topic that you covered till the 3rd slide. Okay, or else an activity also to involve the children. Maybe a question that you ask, the response they sent may be used for an analysis, an evaluation. It can also be that. This is not a quiz. A response, you are taking the responses. You are collecting the opinions. Okay, so here, that is done. After making it, here is at the bottom. Here at the bottom, you can see add to presentation. Hope my screen is visible to you. Add to presentation screen is here. Click on this one. So this slide is added to my Google Slides. Got it? Now again, you will go to the 6th slide. 6th slide is a slide number 6. You will have your content here. Then after making this content, you will go to 7th slide. 7th slide will also have content. You will explain that also. Then after that, you will go to another one. 8th slide is another activity, a word cloud activity to collect opinion, response, etc. So if you click on that word cloud, you can ask a question here. I'll ask, which is your favorite breakfast food? This is almost similar to the word cloud in Mentimeter, but in Mentimeter, we have a restriction that only 2 slides can be created with a free account. Here you can make more. That's why this is the second one in the single slide, and we will take more. Which is your favorite breakfast food? You can add your answers here. Your answers will be recorded. Add to presentation, second one. So how many activities are added now? 2 activities. Again, I'll go with my presentation that is in 10th slide. With material, 11th, slide number 11, material, teaching material, or you can limit to less number also, no problem at all. And now, after this, here, 12 slides have been created. On the 12th one, another activity can be added. Maybe a ranking. Rating is here, ranking, quiz, all these are options. You can rate any activity like this. Look here. It has popped up. How will it look like? The rating on a scale that you give, that will be attended by them. And that rating will be displayed with percentage. That is the activity. Number of maximum value, you can set 5 stars or 6 stars. Anything is possible, right? That is rating. Now, ranking is also there. Ranking, who is your favorite? I'm just giving a sample ranking. I'll ask Sachin whether Sachin is your favorite or Dhoni is your favorite or Kohli is the Kohli. And who is then Rohit? Yeah, who is your favorite? A ranking can be done. This is the order. Okay, so you add this also to the presentation. Now, how many? 3 slides have been added to the presentation. And you can continue with your slides. Maybe 13th slide is here, 13. And the 14th, when you come to 14, let us ask a question, a quiz. your session is over. 30 minutes session delivery is over. Now the remaining few minutes will be used for a quiz. And what is tested in this quiz? The contents that you taught. So the parents, even the parents will come to watch what is happening at the end. Because they know that there is a test at the end. After the after 40 minutes delivery, the teacher will give some questions to the students and they'll have to answer. There will be winner, there will be losers. Loser means, you know, the first prize winner and who comes at the first five spots will also be available there. Okay, so here you ask this question. Who is the education minister of Kerala? Such a question if you ask. This is the one. And here you will write Mrs. Veena, Mrs. Bindu, Mr. Shivankutty. Shivankutty and Mr. Riyas. Suppose if these are the responses you sent. What you have to do is you have to click at the correct answer before sending it. These are not artificial intelligence enabled ones. So they will have, you'll have to give the responses like what you give in Mentimeter. In Mentimeter also you can give a quiz, right? But the answer has to be clicked in advance before entering the session. And you can enable a timer here, you know, set the time, maybe like 15 is default. You can make it 20. And you can show the leaderboard after the question. There will be a leaderboard after each one. So we are going to add this to presentation. Add to presentation. So all my slides are over. I've made all these activities. At the end, if required, you can even add a audience question answer slide. End of that. Any more questions or any responses from the students? Now it's over. See, your contents are ready. This content was prepared before entering the classroom on the previous night itself. Now it's your online session. You entered the classroom and your slides are ready. You just click with present with Slido. Can you see? My slide is there. I'm going to start my presentation. My screen will be seen by the participants. My voice will be heard by the participants. Then from the first topic, I'll give the activity here. Then I'll go to the next. I'll explain the concept. Whatever is the concept to be delivered online, if required. Just go to the next slide. Go to the next slide. Explain the concept. Now the first activity comes to you. I didn't come out of the screen. I don't share any message, but I asked the participants to go to their address bar to type slido.com. The same is requested to you. Now, what you have to do is you just come out of, minimize your screen and you open a window. From that open window, address bar would be there or search bar. You type slido.com, not in the chat box. It should be done from the address bar from Google. Slido.com. When you enter slido.com, you can open that. There will be a column, join as. See, there will be a hash icon. Near that hash, you enter this code. This is the code for this Slido activity, 437090. Once again, I repeat, 437090. And you will join. And what you do will be seen by everyone here, including you. I have the first comment. The one who supports, one who likes slides, marked it here. Now more will come like this. See, those who have joined, don't close that window after this, because throughout this slideshow presentation, we will be using that window. So minimize it and come back to your normal screen. Don't delete it. Don't close it. Okay, throughout. And next time, you don't have to enter slido.com. By the time you reach your window, next question will be open for you. That's the advantage. It's a smart tool. When you reach the next window, means the Slido window, next question that I ask will be ready. But it should appear on my screen, then only it will be available for you. Now it is not available for you. See how many people responded? You can see at the top of the right hand side, 25 people have responded. And what is your response? Slides is the response. commented by many. 41% of the people have commented slides. You love slides. 22% Menti and 19% forms. Padlet 10%. Jamboard no one. My dear educators, this Jamboard is a beautiful tool. If you don't use it effectively, that may be the reason you don't love it. Only 4% believe Jam is a good tool. Jamboard is a smart tool. Please tell me if I want to explain that Jamboard at the end. In case if required, I'll tell. See, now how many people have responded? 53 people. Still people are joining because we have many participants. We have 300 plus participants. So 55 people have responded. Based on this response, I can assume, I can connect, I can analyze. See, this is the conclusion. So that activity is over. It was an online polling. It was an online, voting. So next, let me go to the next slide. After this, after discussing this, I'll complete. I'll move to the next one. Next one is, next slide, sixth slide. Condense, explained. Go to next slide. That is the seventh one. And next one. Next one. Next slide. It's an activity. Which is here? What is your favorite breakfast food? You move to that window where you stopped, where you did the first activity. You write your answer here. It will come. See, your answers are popping up on my screen. Can you say that the students are not able to respond to you? See, the children must also be ready to get the next question. See, within few seconds, 34 people joined here. Look, what is at the center? Dosa and Sambar. Why? That is the one which is commented by majority of you. Similar to Mentimeter. But there is a restriction. Here, this is in the same slide or along with your slides, you make it. See, what can be concluded? There are many items. Chapati, parota, beef. In the morning break, for the breakfast itself, you started eating parota. Parota, beef also. Dosa chutney, dosa sambar, dosa appam, ek put kahoot. Kahoot also. Is it available? Is it an online dish? Anyway.
Online season food.
Season food, yeah, maybe.
Slider, yeah. And all those.
So this, look here, how is it? So how many activities you conducted within this time? With your slides and with your presentation, with your explanation, with your content, with your delivery, two activities. Still, I'll go. Once this is over, so here I'll make the Vidya Sahodaya people prefer dosa and sambar for their breakfast. That is the most repeatedly appeared one. That's why it is in big letters. Next most commented is dosa, appam, dosa and chutney also. Okay, so it's a competition between dosa and chutney and dosa and sambar. Dosa is common element in these two, but sambar and chutney are fighting. Okay, anyway, leave it.
It's participants must be honest, sir.
Yeah. So now, had it been an evening tea, you would have evening snack, you would have variety, right? Now, anyway, it is good that you have only the breakfast item. Otherwise, that would give a temptation for you now. Yeah, let me go to the next one. 75 people responded. You can see all those that there then. Now, we'll go to the 10th slide. Now, you will conclude when explain 11th slide, 12th slide. Now, you rank your players in the order. These are the people. By the time you reach, move to that screen, it will be ready for you. You see, you're very smart people. Look, 6 people, 14 people responded within 22. Very good, very good. Vidya Council teachers, I do appreciate you. Principals, you are molding your teachers very well. That's why I'm getting this response very quickly. See, the ranking goes. So 50, 61, after 60, 61 rankings, votings, Sachin is still at the top. Just behind Sachin is Dhoni, Kohli is third and Rohit is fourth. How many responses? 66. Similarly, rating is also possible for you. Then open general comments, you know, without any structure, if I enable that activity, anything can be pasted in the screen. Anything means, you know, comments. It will float like, it will be floating through the screen. Once the screen is over, then it will scroll up and the remaining parts will come down. Is it okay? This activity is also conducted. Now I'll just click enter key. I'm with the 13th slide. After explaining things, lie. I'll ask a question. Now you have to go to that screen. By the time there will be an option for you to write your name to join the quiz. You must write your name. And I'll get who all have joined. Haseena, Ramsia, Sharmila, Sunila, Haziba, Prakash, Rashida, Rahila. Many are there. Now 46 people have joined for this. These are the participants for the quiz competition. What is this quiz? About or on the topic that you taught, on the content that you delivered so far, or 40 minutes session, right? No additional activities required to assess them. No additional activities required to check whether they were attentive. And inform the parents that at the end of the session, there will be a test also. At least during that time, the parents will come to see who all score marks and who is the winner. There is a kind of healthy competition within this. Because the one who writes, one who is the quickest will be the top. And here also, I'm going to play this one. You have only 20 seconds time. And if I click the right arrow key, you will see the question is ready. Who is the education minister of Kerala? Countdown started. 20, 30, 17, 16, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Here is it. This is the response. There were 69 people responded. And 6% said Veena George. 3% said Bindu. She is in the higher education. Nobody voted for Riyas, but because you know he's the public work department, right? I think. And there is Shivan Kutty, 91%. If I click on the right arrow, I'll get the right answer. Whether it is correct, Shivan Kutty is correct. So 91% of the people responded the correct answer. So that means the teaching that I did was, you know, the class which I took was understood, comprehended by the children. This is the conclusion. But still, there are few who had doubts. That's why that 99% doubt was there. So 9% of 69 is almost 7 people. 7 people failed to understand, grasp the content. Now here is the reflection for the teacher. Teacher understood whether that concept was clear for the children. Children understood whether my answer was correct or not. So this learning never ends. You know, the learning which happened in the classroom was concrete. That became a very concrete now. And their doubt has been clarified. Now, even that 9% understood that their answer was wrong and it is Sivan Kutty. So because everyone sees this. Everyone sees. Now, the curiosity is to know who is the champion. Who is after the first round? Similar rounds can be conducted. Who is the first one? It is Muhammad Tufail K. Yeah. Within 3 seconds, answered this question. So congratulations, Muhammad Tufail. Wherever you are from, I think you are from. Would you please text in the chat box which school are you from? Let there be an appreciation. Not because you are quickest. You are the quickest. That's why. And Insaf, 4 seconds. Haseena, 4 seconds. Prakash, is it Prakash sir? Are you there? Are you the one?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, you are one among the top podium finishers. Okay.
We came all to respond so fast.
Yeah. Everyone was so quick and fast. And Basit A. Rahman, 4 seconds. See, that is there. Congratulations. Now, similarly, you can conduct a few more rounds. Is it meaningful? At the end, if there is any question from the participants, this is the platform. Do you have any comment about the session? For you also, you can comment here. Now look here. The screen is ready for you. Can you comment here? There is a comment. Any of your comment will pop up here. Is it a question to me? Or is it a comment to me? Anything. Yeah. Here is it. Hello. Good. Superb. Good. Great. Do we need to download? No. You don't have to download. You have to add an extension only first time. Next time onwards. One more question, sir. Good class. Hi. Good. Super. It's great. Wonderful. Children would really enjoy. Hello. Beautiful. Great. Wonderful. Superb. Wow. Excellent. Super. Superb. Awesome. Superb. Superb. Yeah, all your comments are coming here. Can we use the tool to the mobile? Mobile, you know, presentation would be difficult. And when we go to the second year, I would request everyone to find a solution to present your screens. through a web option. Otherwise, there will be issues for the participants to attend. Okay, in the first year, I know among you, some schools have devised some strategies, right, for laptops and desktops. So if possible, and the senior classes also, senior and junior classes, if you want to give online tools and activities and integrate tools and activities with your sessions, the best thing to present your class is a desktop or a laptop. Yeah. That is not possible. There are some limitations. Anyway, when we get some tools, there will be some limitations also. We cannot see the names of the students who did not take part. That option is not available. Hope this is clear. So this 63 people responded. That task is over. You got it? New interaction can be added. Now you see different activities. This quiz question was there. Reset results. If you reset this result, the same can be played in the next class also. If you have two classes, in the morning one, afternoon another division, you can reset all these results so that the same can be seen by, same can be used for other classes. So one time preparation is only required. And there is an advantage for you. If you are a parallel teacher, if you want to share the contents that you created, here is a share option. Hope this option is available for you, because you share Google Sheets, you share Google Slides, you share Google Jamboard. All these can be shared with editor option. Editor right. If you give editor right to the one who gets shared, they will also have the equal right like you. So you don't have to carry with the pen drives. You don't have to carry this with your system. Wherever you go, if there is a connection, you can play that. This is an advantage. The Google tools, if you use, all these are saved directly to your Google account. Suppose if you have a device at home and there is another one in school, see, this both can need not to be copied. This content need not to be copied with these devices. Just go and log in with your account, then present it from the system. This is an advantage. If there is any question, you can ask this question. And definitely, I think these questions will be compiled by the organizers towards the end, right? And that I'll try to attend those questions. Do you have any question? If I give you the platform open for you to ask the question now, since the number of participants are more, since we have 478 participants, it will be very noisy and it will cut our precious time, right? We are going to discuss about more tools. So you may please send your queries, which will be answered at the end. Can I go to the next one? Give me.
Yes, sir.
Any question? If you have any question, Salil sir, Prakash sir, those hosts, if you have any question regarding this, you can ask. On behalf of entire participants, if you have any question, you can ask. Nothing, right? So is it useful?
They have asked a question, whether please show once again adding Slido to a slide.
Slido to a slide. Yeah, okay, fine. That's okay. Now, see, initially what I suggested was, you have to type from the address bar, Slido extension to Google. This is only one time. I had added this 2 years back. I mean, 1 year back, last year. Still, it is there with me. And in between that, I changed my device. Actually, I was adding that to my Google Chrome, to my Google. So Slido extension to Google is to be typed. Click here. And you will find Slido for Google extension, or else you can directly go to Google Workplace Market, Google Marketplace. From there also you can select. And this is Slido for Google. Look, it's a slides add-on. It's an add-on to Slide. It's a third-party app, but a very productive one. Don't hesitate to accept this one. And here, when you add, it will show install, because that is new to you. And mine is uninstalled. Since it has already been installed, it gives me uninstall message. So this will be installed for you. You click on so that it will be installed. And the second thing is to join. Open slides. Open, these slides can be opened from the 9 dots. Click here on this screen. It's opened. And all the previously created ones are here, including the one which I created for this demo session. Because this is automatically saved. You don't have to save. If you want to click that, you can click it. If you want to remove, you can remove that as well. So I'm going to show you another one, a blank one. So in order to add a blank one, click on this plus button. Here is. And now you see, this is your Google Slides. If you have already added Slido, you will see this add-on. All the add-ons will be seen there. I have Slido is the only Slido is the add-on. And if I don't know how to operate this Slido, there is a tutorial. You can open this tutorial. A Slido tutorial will be opened. Look, this is a Slido tutorial. Everyone can learn this Slido tutorial. It's attached with that. Got it? Yeah. This is, do you want to add polls? It is giving there. A tutorial is there. That is the first thing. Then, otherwise, after first round or on the first one itself, we can have an activity. How? Click on Slido now. Now, the Slido menu is among the menus in the menu bar. Click on that. It will work. At the right side, you will see a Slido screen. There will be a green color to create a session. Click on this create a session. And it will ask you what kind of an activity. Multiple choice, open text, word cloud, rating, ranking, quiz, audience. These are the options available. Got it? After making it, you present with Slido. That's all. A code will be generated. That code has to be entered by the participants. Throughout one class, a single code will work. So that is enough. Is it okay now? Can I go? Can I go further? Hope this is yes, clear. Sir. Yeah. So fine. Thank you. Now, many of you say, especially mathematics teachers, I heard it from mathematics teachers that they struggle to write their content. Chemistry teachers say, cannot write these structures. We spend a lot of time to make PowerPoint presentation and Slido. And real-time writing and a ready-made content, these two are two different. If you can write real-time, it will be a fine experience for the participants when they do. You can use it, but an additional spending is required for that. And that's not too much as well. So I'll show you how. One thing, how can you write? Where can you write? Where can you get a virtual whiteboard? Virtual whiteboard is available from Jamboard. Jamboard is a virtual whiteboard. A plus button is only required here. And now here you can write. See here, option. We have option to write here. 1, 4, 2, 3, 6. Yeah. But it is very difficult, right? With the mouse. And if you don't have a touch screen, it is a bit difficult. So this is this can be operated from both mobile phone and laptop. So simultaneously it will work. For example, if I have a mobile phone with a Jamboard, I can click on the Jamboard. If I have a Jamboard here in it, I haven't installed it in the mobile phone. And if I have a Jamboard, I can write here. What I write here will also be automatically synchronized here. And this is one board. Okay, leave it. I'm going to show you another board. Tell me whether you can see or not. Now I'm taking a very free one, but very much useful one from my OneNote for Windows 10. Can you see? Please confirm whether you can see my screen or not. This is OneNote for Windows.
We can see, sir.
OneNote for Windows is a free tool from Microsoft family. If you are using Windows 10, you can use this. If it is the previous versions, you can use OneNote 16. And if it is already available with the installed Windows, you operate it from here. If not available, you can go to Microsoft.
Screen is not being seen, sir.
Screen is not being seen.
No. Only the jam is.
Jamboard is. Jamboard
okay,
is.
Okay. Okay. No. Check whether you can see now. Along with the Jamboard, something else. OneNote for Windows 10. Can you?
No, sir. No.
because I get only two options here for me. Normally, when we share, the entire screen can be shared. And the other one, I have only two options here. That's why it's something different from the normal. I think it is basic.
Maybe.
Okay. Basic, advanced. Okay. Can you see now anything there?
No, you are not sharing, sir. You exited. Now Google is
Google visible. Is seen, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Maybe this is also seen now, right? From the start button, I clicked. Yeah, OneNote for Windows. I did not open anything. I just placed my cursor on that particular menu, only that is there. Now we check whether you can see anything now on the screen.
That Google screen only we can see.
Yeah, maybe now it is visible, right?
And now it is seen, sir.
Only two options are available for me here. That's why. Okay. Anyway, see, this is operated. This is opened from Microsoft. Okay, we have our programs in the start button, right? If you click on the start button, this will be available for you. So you get it from there, or else you can add it from the Google, not Google, it is Microsoft Store. This is OneNote. This is a beautiful package, especially for mathematics teachers and all. Anybody can use it. And what is the advantage with this? Here we have insert option, drawing option, etc. And in drawing, you know, you can write here. This is also a smart board. This is also a smart board. And how to write here X square, all these things, there is an insert option. Mathematics teachers, if you insert table, you can insert file, you can insert printout, you can insert pictures, you can online video can also be inserted, audio can be inserted, meeting file, symbol, equation. See this equation column? Can you see the equation A square plus B square? How easily you can insert this? Normally, it is very difficult to type, right? All these things, structures here. See, all these structures can be constructed. That is why this is loved by the mathematics teachers. Subscript, superscripts, yeah, X bar Y, you know, X by Y, this all roots, all these shapes can be inserted. Symbols can be inserted.
Sir, symbols alone are available?
Yeah, symbols alone.
Can we insert the matter in between?
Yes, we can. Yeah, anything, anywhere, if you want, you can insert this. Okay, if this screen is free, there you can insert. Okay, as a file or symbols. This is what I say. This symbol, you know, if you want to add this symbol theta, this theta is here. Can you see here? Here is that theta.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yeah, similarly. Okay, so then the advantage is that you can write here. If you can write real time, how happy you would be, especially mathematics teachers. So I'll show you one. Yeah. Hope you can see now my Google. Are you able to see Google, or is it the previous one only?
Previous one only, sir.
Yeah, let me just come back to Google then. Each time I'll
show. The application's name is OneNote, no?
OneNote. Microsoft OneNote. Now here, I'll show you one XP pen. This is a smart pen. XP pen. If you can add this, I'll not compel anybody to buy. But if you purchase this, this will be a smart idea. Your teaching will be a very efficient one. Your children will love it. You will never be spending your late nights for preparing slides and PowerPoints. Instead, you will make it live. And when you make live writing with a device like this, it will definitely impress your participants and definitely your parents as well. So here you just see, this is available. It varies from 1,000 to 6,000, 7,000. Good company pens are available. Different digital parts can be purchased. This is an XP pen, and this costs 6,000 plus, but still it is not available now. No delivery is available. And there are average 3,000 items are available. 3,000 rupee items are available. I'll just play one video. How can this be connected with it? You just purchase this and you just play this from your connect this with your laptop. Then you write on this particular part. What you write on this particular part will be appearing on your writing screen. So real-time writing is possible. Construction type, problem type questions can be live completed in the classroom. So that is the advantage. This is not a promotional video or promotional session. I couldn't purchase them recently. I came to know about this recently only. I'll tell you the background behind this proposal. I'll tell you. It can be connected either through a cable or else Wi-Fi modes are also there. Different modes are there.
An average 3,500 it is available, sir.
Yeah, it is available. An average 3,000 XP pen. Look here, the advantage. Hope you understood the advantage if you use it. What I said, I showed you a Jamboard. Here you can write. What you write will be appearing there. The second one what I showed was this one. OneNote. And if you write all these things in the OneNote, here is an option for you to share. Look here at the extreme right hand side, the same thing that you used with Google, you can share with your participants. Normally, when you write notes on the text blackboard or whiteboard, that will be copied by the students to their notebook. Here you have an interesting option that you can type their email address and share this with an editing option. They can also get it. They can also do the work. Your board will be their board. Your note can be shared like this. See, if you don't want to give the edit access to them and share this live, there is an option. You can download this. You can download, you can take the printout of this, and that can also be shared with the participants. See, this is print option. Look here at the extreme right, there is a print option. When you take a printout, you see, you will get print Primo PDF or any PDF option can be chosen. Portrait or any of these can be taken and just type print. It will be a printed matter. So if you share this printed matter, how beautiful it would be. Children will get this and they will get their content. And you can even upload this in your Google Classroom. You can upload this in Parklet. Wherever you want to upload, it can be uploaded. Still, if you want to share it with your website, it can be done. And if you can, if you want, you can share this with your Google or your YouTube channels or with your WhatsApp groups. So these are many options. See, printout option is here. I told you this is printout. Any printout can be added. You can add any picture from file or even directly from the camera, it can be added. Now there is an error because I'm using my camera since it is a live session. That's why. Any file, suppose if you want to add a file from here, suppose this is the file which I would like to add. Any file, Pragyada guidelines. If I want to add this file, I can add, upload to OneDrive or insert as an attachment or insert as a printout. If I insert this as a printout, that will be inserted here. So on your screen, you get a printout also. Any file that has been saved in your system can be inserted as a printout. Unfortunately, what I added was a document which contains 100 plus pages, so it will take time. But you please don't hesitate to add anything. You see, look, this is inserted here. This is a file. I could insert another file, which is a PDF, into my OneNote. So any, even your textbook, that can be inserted here. A particular page can be inserted here. A reference material can be inserted here. Another material you prepared can be inserted here, and that can be attached with your notes. So this is a beautiful option. Any, see, even picture directly you can add. From file, if there is any picture to be added, that picture can be added. Okay, any picture. Table, if you want to draw a table, that table can be drawn. See here, you see table. Okay, so work with this. This is a wonderful tool. Lot of tutorials are also available on this. Drawing option is also there. Different drawing options. So you see pens, colors, different colors. For the small kids, you can use this pencil-like. Pencil is also there. Okay, then highlighter, marker, different colors. You see, any color can be chosen. this color can also be chosen. Okay, and if you edit and share the edit option, edit permission to the participants, they can complete their work and you can even mark it and again take the printout and send it back. So the mark
that is one of the questions that they asked is the same, sir, whether the children also can work on our page.
Directly, they cannot, I guess. Yeah, you give them edit option. They can.
Since you in Jamboard, we can share it and the students can work real time. No?
Yeah, yeah. This is also, you give the edit permission. When you share this, you give the edit permission there. Send an email invitation. Type email address. I think it is. You please try here. Have you opened it, Prakash sir? Do you have this OneNote with you? Have you opened it?
No, no, I have not tried.
No, no. You can try it later. Teachers in small groups can try there. Otherwise, I would have checked it here. So, do you want to insert shapes here? Yeah, these shapes. All the geometric shapes like this can also be done. Like
some of our teachers are doing. Math teachers are doing that.
They are doing this one, right? Yes, fine. So, here you see these geometric shapes can also be inserted directly along with this. And whatever you... option is there. Yeah, this can be done. Got it? Fine. Shall I go to the next one? I have one more to tell you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, a beautiful one. And this is one of the recommendations I would make. Everybody, all the CBSE schools, let us make it. If you have already made it, okay, go ahead.
The common question is whether we can connect it with a mobile.
This would not be. This is from Windows. Okay.
Okay,
this
sir.
Is from Windows only. Yeah. Now, so you please try. I'll tell you the reason why I showed you this writing part and all. We had a session for Chennai region. And one of the best schools in Chennai region. Chennai region means, you know, it was part of Kakinada because it was in Hyderabad from Secunderabad. They have been added to Chennai region recently. And that is DP, Delhi Public School, Nachora. They have 25,000 students and teachers have made a studio in their houses. So online classes are being done very smartly, smoothly with live presentations. And there is one more device. I'll just tell you what is that. You can also try that if possible. It doesn't have much expenditure, especially for chemistry, science teachers and all. See, that is a digital board that you create yourself. Only a glass piece like this. So it will be
now
kept
with... your Jamboard is presented.
Yeah, visible. Yeah, only that is it. You know, I'm not showing anything. I'm just talking to you.
Okay.
See, a screen, you know, look here, my video. Just look at my video. See, I'm talking in front of my webcam now, right? There is nothing between me and my webcam. But in that, a screen will be here. A screen means a glass. That glass will be connected with some LED lights. And there is a special pen to write on this LED. Now, if it is between me and my camera, I can write here. Now, like this. See, I write like here. Education. When I write here with that pen, you all will see what I write there. You got it. Let me just show you. I'll just try to show you that here. Check whether this picture is, my screen is available. No, not. This need not to be immediately, but at a later stage, if you want, you can make it. Okay. Yeah, here. Can you see my screen now?
It's still Jamboard, sir.
Jamboard only. Okay, fine. Hope you can see now.
Yeah, now it is visible.
Now look there. There is a light board. Can you see?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So writing is possible with this. So you don't keep a board behind. You keep a board between your camera and yourself. This is a big one. A small one can be done. There are some videos, light board exercises. You try in the Google's YouTube, you will find some. Just like they said, it's around 300 rupees for the, 3000 rupees for the preparation. It's not available to purchase as it is, something to be done. Someone who is interested in this techno matters will definitely be able to install that without much.
You can fix it onto our table.
Yeah, it can be fixed on our table. Yeah, it can be used. If you have a big table, a partition can be made. One is to keep your laptops at the other side. And here yourself and your hands and your materials to write all these things. That will be seen by them. Okay, fine. These are second round activities that can be done. Now, let me come back. I'll show you a very essential tool to be used. Now, once again, let me go back. And I'm moving back to my screen here. This is Google Sites. Can you see now? Sorry to ask like this, because it's only because my second device is not. Normally, I keep the two devices. And from the second device, I can see whether others are seeing this or
visible
not.
Visible or not. Yeah. It is visible.
So thank you for prompting that well from your end. Thank you. Google Sites. What if you can make a site for a website for your class 6, class 7, class 8, that too free of cost, without paying anything? How would that be? That is what is Google Sites. You can make Google websites. Google Sites, sign in. So click here. This year, if you can make it, there is an advantage. One, there will be a permanent area, a reservoir for you to keep all your resources, all your links and videos and materials and questions and extra questions and all the contents. Second, there will be a mouth publicity that the children will start speaking about your website. They'll say, I have a website. We have a website. Parents will also say that, yeah, they have a website. School is doing that very well because they have a website in their school. School has website, class website. Who will manage this? Teachers. And what will be managed? Materials and contents, information. That is possible. So this is also from Google. Same way you can click on this plus button to start a new one. But here I'll advise you in the beginning, since we all are not experts in artistic works, decorative works, there is a template available. So you can go to that template by clicking on this template gallery, which is here. Template gallery is here. Now, you scroll down, you will see in the template gallery, three options in education. One is a class site. Another one is a club site. Name of the club in the school can be put here. See, this is a digital era and you are finding it difficult to keep their materials, students' portfolio. A digital portfolio can also be created. Children in the higher classes, ask them to create one with this. About them, their digital, their achievements, everything can be done. Even the materials that they submit can be kept, a copy can be kept. Let them submit individually. Those schools who have G Suite license can use it very easily because 500 GB limit is there for you. You have a lot of space in the space. Google Drive, right? Space is available. So here, click on this ready-made template, or else you can make similar one if you are a smart artist. I clicked on this school. See, I'm going to make a Google Class website within next few minutes, just 10 minutes. Let's spend 10 minutes to make it. Here, you can make the class name, any class name. So for example, let me make it 6A. Anything can be done. 6A. If you want to add your school name also here, that's possible, 6A. What I suggest is in higher classes, subject-wise, you can make chemistry, class 10 chemistry, class 10 physics, class 10 biology. So only one teacher will be there. In classes before 9th, it is better to have a class site. Okay, now look, how can it be made? See, this is like 6A is added here. You can add the class name here again, that 6A is added. Where is 6A? And a logo can be added. Your own school logo can be added here. For example, I'll say, if you click there, you can upload. And you can upload. I'll upload from desktop. This is my BIS logo, my school logo. I added this one here. Can you see logo here? The left side, here you can see the logo. Similarly, here is a big picture. This is a template. You can change this image. You can upload any file. Your school photo, if required, you can add that photo. Look here, I changed that photo back. Or if that particular class has a photo, a group photo of the students can also be added. Anything can be uploaded. See, now you see these two. Look, this is the homepage. There are in the template which is copied, there are class overviews. You can either keep it or else remove and add your own. See, editing is easy. You don't have to be an HTML expert or a Java expert to make a website. Just cut and copy, paste it and add. any file can be added, any photo can be uploaded. If there is any file, you add it, or if there is anything to be chosen. And suppose from here, Ansar School, Thrissur, if there is any picture available, it will show. Yeah. Is it one of, I think it is one of, anyway, any photo, let you, you take any photo. Suppose if this is the photo to be added, okay, this one, okay. That photo will be added here. So any photo, any video, this photo can also be deleted or added. Something else to be added. About your class teacher, all these things can be added here. Any link, student sites can be linked here. Parent sites can be linked here. School forms can be linked here. Even online payment portal can be activated from here. Okay, no, a link can be. They should not struggle to pay the fee. Okay, that is one of their worries now, right? Their worries, right? Concerns. Now, so here, what else can be added here? You can insert text box. So that means if you add a text box, anything can be added here like this. Got it? And they can add any image from anywhere can be added. Upload and select. You can add embedded. Suppose if there is a link to be added, let me take a link from the website. I'll take a YouTube link, and this link will be attached here. And if I attach such a link here in the class site, this video will be available for the students from a single click. You have many videos like that, right? You share it with WhatsApp groups and Telegram groups, right? It's not required here. You just directly come and paste it here. That will be available for the whole academic year. What all contents you share in the WhatsApp groups will be deleted, or that may be misplaced somewhere. It may be lost, or due to this WhatsApp policies, after 30 days, that may be lost. Some parents will come that we didn't get it, I couldn't find it. But you can tell them that everything is available and everyone will visit that also. So anything. What else can be added here? Look. You just scroll down. You have a placeholder, cloud search, YouTube, calendar, map, docs, slides. For example, if you want to add a docs with your slides, your notes and all, you prepare notes, right? Example, this one, I'm going to add this one. Insert. That Google Docs will be added here. And I think you are using this Google Docs for preparing question papers and all, because multi-language options are available. Speaking practice is only required. You just speak, what you speak will be appearing as a text there, right? You can convert to a PDF directly by downloading it. So that is the option. So any of these can be used. This is directly from Google. No additional expenditure would come in the future also. Different layouts are available there. And you can add even pages. Look, how is it now? There is a home page, schedule, and newsletter. You can add a page by clicking here. You can change the themes by choosing here. Different themes are there. And I'm going to add a page. And I'm going to add a duplicate home page by clicking the three dots here. Here, if you click, you can add a duplicate page. And I'll add subjects. Done. Now you will find there is a menu for subjects. And in the subjects, in sixth standard, if you want, you can add a sub page. First time I add a duplicate page. Now in this subject page, a sub page will be added, and that sub page will be English. Done. Now I have a subject, and the subject English will appear. Again in the subject, I'll add another sub page, and that sub page will be Malayalam. See, two. Now you look, a child who comes to this can go to subject and they can go to Malayalam, and that Malayalam page is ready. Malayalam teacher can decorate. Decorate means add Malayalam contents, YouTube's, notes, everything in the Malayalam page. Clear now? See, then again, if you want again one more, for example, if you want to make a duplicate page, notes. If you have a practice of giving notes, all the notes can be pasted like this in the notes. In the notes also, you can add duplicate sub pages, English or Malayalam or things like this. like this. Knots. You got it? So additional questions, extra questions, all these can be done like this. You check how is the appearance. I'm going to the home page. If you check, it will look like this. This is your website. It will not be like this. We took only 2 minutes to do this, right? Like this. That video is there. If you click on that video there, it will work from there. That video will work from here. Yeah. Got it? Yes, it's there. And now you can see that file that you uploaded. That file is also available there. And there is the videos, photos, everything is available. Okay. Now, what you can do here? Here is an option for you to share with others. See, this is a website which is for class 6. So all the teachers who teach in this class should be editors. So when you share this, add people. For example, if I add people here, I can give the right, editor right or viewer right. You can give editor right to the teachers and viewer right to the students. So students will never be able to edit anything. Instead, they will be able to access all the information and everything that you give here. And after that, you can publish this. There is an option for you to publish. Publish this as a website. There will be a website name like https, sites.google.com. I am using my personal G Suite. That's why it is jojipol.com. If you have a school with a G Suite account, that name will be displayed. Then 6A will be the website address. Using this address, children will be able to join. After 1 year, see, all your children can be removed from this class and new set of students can be added there. See, in case if child joins after 3 months, all the information, all the materials shared with this platform will be accessible for that student. Suppose if a teacher leaves in between after 3 months, all the resources shared by the teacher will be available for the students, and then next teacher can just join. That's all. So this is very much important. And more than the utility, what I suggest is, why I suggest this is new to everyone, right? And if we can use it, and if we can publicize that we have these resources, at least the parents will be convinced that you had right preparedness for this session. You had very good planning for the session, so that they'll have a feeling that the lives of the children will be safe. Let us do some strategies and some tactics like this to make it spread among the fraternity. You got it? Hope you will use it. You have smart people, you have IT department and teachers. Initially, with the help of the IT teacher, you just start doing this, and rest of the, all the classes can be done by the teachers. Shall I go to the next one? And I think we are approaching the last few minutes. So just give me time here to show one science tool. I don't know whether you have tried this or not. FET.colorado.edu. Have you done FET? Science teachers, have you done FET? FET is available from FET Colorado, which is set up by FET University of Colorado. Look here. Simulations are available for physics, chemistry, maths, earth science, and biology. All the simulations are available. Can you see my screen? Prakash sir,
Yes, sir.
From here, I'm going to take chemistry. For example, a chemistry practical activity can be shown. It will take some time because this we have more participants, 400 plus participants. That's why, yeah, all the chemistry topics available for demonstration will be displayed here. These are the ones. And if one of these is useful for you to be shown to the participants, live presentation is possible. I don't know whether you're using OLAPS. Are you using OLAPS? Amrita OLAPS? That is a beautiful one. Even for the English, it is available. Look here, concentration. Suppose if I want to show the children concentration, how the concentration changes when components are changed. A FET simulation, interactive simulation is possible. Look here. See, here is this. I can check the concentration. It is zero. Now see the meter doesn't run. And I just move, I add drink mix. See, now if I check, the concentration increases. Instead of this anything, potassium chromate, I can add potassium chromate. See, look here. This is the concentration. I can add water. I can remove water. Real like in a laboratory, you can do this like this. Got it? If you want to add more, yeah. Instead of this solid, if you want to add this liquid, liquid can be added. Water can be added. Concentration can be tested like this. This is FET. This is from FET. Okay. And in simulation, again, there is chemistry. And in chemistry, there is phase changes that can also be known. And chemistry teachers, in the meantime, I'll show you one more, that is Chem Collective. Chem Collective. If you try Chem Collective, Chem Collective, chemistry teachers, Chem Collective is also a virtual package. Many virtual apps are available with this Chem Collective, especially in the higher classes for the 11th and 12th. It is very much useful. So here again, now the phase changes. How can you show the states of matter basics? States of matter here. I'll open this one. Let that take some time. And Chem Collective also is a useful one. And I don't know whether you are using augmented reality. Unfortunately, I cannot play it from my device, mobile. AR Lupa is there. There is one for NCRT class 9 and 10. Have you explored through? Please note down E-Pathshala AR. Your NCRT physics, chemistry, biology materials can be digitally seen on your mobile phone with a smart application that is called AR. E-Pathshala
AR.
E-Pathshala AR. Okay, E-Pathshala AR. And I think Socratic is another mobile application that can be used. Socratic. And for in smaller classes, if you are a teacher in smaller classes, you can use this auto draw. It's a very simple one, auto draw. Look, some pictures can be drawn like this. There are some natural artists among you, but I'm not a natural artist. For if I want to show the small children some tool, some active, I can just use this autodraw.com. Using this, if I want to draw a tree, this is enough for me. See, how is my tree? When I drew this tree, I got a suggestion at the top, because this is an automate, this is an artificial intelligence. I got a suggestion. This, did you mean this tree? Did you mean this tree? Yes, this is the one I meant. Look, my tree has turned to be a real tree. And here, filling is easy for us. Color can be changed. You can make it a tree. Similarly, anything that you draw here with auto draw will give you the exact thing. You know, this is my house. This is what I draw. But when I draw a house like this, suddenly I'll get some suggestion. Did you mean this? This is what I meant. Look, so this can be copied to your screens. We can minimize for match the following type of questions. So for showing the children, yeah, see. Simple, natural artist, normal ones. States of matter, I'll show you here. And, you know, since it is taking time, that's why I moved to the other tool, and we could also save the time. So auto draw is another one. So, you know, you have been using Padlet. Hope you are using Padlet, right? Poplet is also a similar one. Poplet is for mind maps, concepts maps. You can use it. Okay. Poplet. P-O-P-P-L-E-T. And some tutorials are available with that Google Interactive. We had a session, no? We had a certified program for 10 hours from Google, right? Google and CBSE. Technology for blended learning, right? Or technology for flipped classroom, something of that sort, right? So there are many videos available. All the videos are connected with Poplet, Wakelet, etc. are included in it. You can just go through that. Okay, now... Then mathematics teachers, you can again try RoboCompass. RoboCompass can also be tried. Mathematics, RoboCompass. Open RoboCompass option is there. And there are some simulations and some activities like this. Look, here examples are given. During this example, you can take it. You can register, sign in to save your work. Then you can take works and you can go to home and take whatever is available. I don't know which are things available here, but you can still explore. RoboCompass.com is the one. Okay. RoboCompass. Now, do you have any other questions? I'll come back. It's taking little time. Before entering the class, you can do this because this is a simulation and here more than 464 participants are there. That's why it is taking a bit time. And if you open it and enter the classroom, it will be okay. But in between that, I had to do this. Because I have
a question whether there is any application for Malayalam.
Why should we have an application for Malayalam? Because we are able to present it through any smart area, any smart board. You have your voice and a beautiful platform. Then second thing, you know, in order to type, we have Google Docs. Google Docs can be used for voice typing. Any content can be created and ready-made items. And don't expect that subject-specific items will be available like Malayalam ones for free. Because who will use it? Very few people who speak Malayalam here. Nobody would be interested in that, right? You know, and the materials which are available free are globally available ones, like Mentimeter. You see, this is globally. Padlet, these are not Indian. So in Indian languages and subjects, it is not available. Common, general ones will be available. And if available, they will have some hidden charges also. So I don't know whether you have tried this Testmos or not. For you all, I'll just give you one examination tool also. That is Testmos. Testmos is a powerful tool for online examinations. You have been doing this with the Google Forms. The same is possible with Testmos. Testmos is a free account, and it can have a paid account. With paid account, the essay type questions can also be done. Okay, here, Testmos, build a test. Name can be given. This is Vidya. I'll add this Vidya Council. I'll add a password 3456. 3456. A test will be created. Now, these are the items available in the dashboard. One is questions. Here I can add a question. Insert option is here from multiple choice question. Who is the Chief Minister of Kerala? I can add a question. This can be edited like this. You know, formatting options are available. This is not available with Google Form, right? Formatting. So here choice, it is Pindrai Vijayan. And it is Ramesh Chenitala. Okay, and the third one is with Kunyali Kutty. And another one is with K. Surendran. Let that be for these people. I'll add PV as Pindrai Vijayan as the correct answer. Just click on this. Don't have to save anywhere. Insert another type of question, that is true or false type questions can be added. Today is Sunday. Is today Sunday? No, it is false. So you can just click here. Now insert again. Another type, fill in the blank. This is an addition and attraction as well, because Dash is the capital of India. This Dash is the capital of India. Actually, what is the capital of India? New Delhi. So you can add an answer here in this column given to you. New Delhi. Suppose in case someone writes Delhi alone, that should also be counted as a correct answer, right? That option is available. Add a possible answer and you can add Delhi here. In case if someone writes New Delhi without a space between W and D, that can also be added as a possible answer. So that means in this question, whether they write New Delhi, Delhi or New Delhi together, all these three will be counted. This option is not available there with Google Form. You got it. So multiple possibilities, possible answers can be added in languages also. There can be some one or two answers, right? This is possible with this. These three, I make these three questions. With a free account, you can create 50 questions that can be sent to 100 people. 100 people can attend at a time with a single test. 50 questions can be added, different types of questions like this. See, after this, I can just click on publish. Just below the questions, there is publish button. Add publish and click on this publish button again. And I add it. Now it is available. I can copy the link and just share this with the participants like what we did before. Here you have everyone in the meeting. You have this. Only 100 people can join, and never it reached more than 100 in the previous activities. So I don't think we will have more than that here also. So please click and join. I can give you 10, 20 seconds. After that, I'll check the results. When I check the results, all your answers, answer sheets, and marks will be appearing here on my screen. And I can copy that to any file. Even the time that you took to complete the task will also be displayed. Your starting time and your ending time. Such a comprehensive one, that too of free cost. You see? I asked you three. And that states of matter basics is running there. I think you understood that part. You know, I'm not going to work with that again. You please explore through FET.colorado.edu. All the available items and activities can be done free of cost without any spending. Okay. Now, Vidya, I'm going back. Since you got much time, I'll click on results. Look here what I do. I click on results. Now you look, you can see 61 people responded. All your answer sheets are here with me. Your scores are here with me. If I want to go to a particular one, Anagha, If I click on Anaga, Anaga's answer sheet will also be displayed here. I didn't save anywhere. It was saved automatically. Here, what is the total number of response? 86. What is the average time taken by these 86 students? 15 seconds. What is the average score of the class? 97. And what is the starting time? Ajit Lal took only 10 seconds. 7 seconds for Alina's. Very quick. Anas took only 7 seconds. All those who take time, more than 10 seconds, 10 between 10 to 11, 15, all these can be seen from here. Your score, the first score, second score, whether there is any mistake for anyone. If there is any mistake for anyone like this, what was mistake? Instead of New Delhi, wrote it ND there. It was a mistake. That's why that mark was lost. Similarly, you can also try out. After this, you can export this. Here is an option for export, right? If you export from here, you just copy this and put it in the MS Word or Excel. That's all. So my dear educators, you are smart learners. I loved this platform with you. It was an opportunity for me to spend my time with you smart people. Thank you very much, Vidya Council. Thank you very much, all the principals who are working with the schools, working in these schools. I had visited many of your schools representing Macmillan, and I had conducted some exclusive sessions for Vidya Council schools when you had Macmillan sessions, right? Even after that, I've been, even recently during this pandemic, just before the